Hey, happy Sunday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Now, I'm going to give you the latest update, not only what's going to be forming soon over here by the Gulf, the Southeast, by Florida, the Western Caribbean. I'm still showing this is our area of the next storm, potentially going to the Gulf, potentially going right out along the East Coast. Plus, we have newly formed Invest 95L and what's going to be right over the Carolinas. This is where it starts getting that rotation from the atmosphere as it heads west. You can see it is heading west at 5 miles per hour right now, and it is predicted to start going a little bit northwest at the last minute. Now, whether it becomes tropical or subtropical, the impacts are still going to be the same, and you can see the winds are offshore on this system. It's not bringing a lot of winds. It's bringing a little bit of rain, but it's also bringing a little slight chance of a tornado threat as we go in for tomorrow. It's mostly right along the coast of the North Carolina, but you got some of South Carolina as well. You got a 2% chance for tornadoes, and that's going to be about it on that system. It's not showing a big anything. Now, the difference between tropical and subtropical, if it's tropical, all the thunderstorms are around the center, and that's where the winds will be. You know how it is for hurricane season. But when it's subtropical, it's all around the outer bands, and you got a huge center, and the winds are not really intense around the center. So it really reaches further with the storms when it's subtropical versus the tight winds on tropical. And what we're seeing is subtropical, a big wide range of thunderstorms trying to tighten up at the last second and become tropical. Either way, it's the same impacts. Now, if this does get a name, it will be, I believe, Helene, the name like that, the H storm. And the next one is going to be the I name storm. And now, historically speaking, I name storm is the most retired letter. And this is where we have a big area of favorable environment where this storm is still going to be forming and shooting either towards the Gulf or towards the East Coast. I'm going to give you the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long. I will show you all the latest information every single day of everything I show you. I won't tell you a story and never come back to it. Now, other than the severe weather on getting some chances for tornadoes for tomorrow as you go by the Carolinas, it's not showing a lot of threats on anything else. We have barely a little chance for tornadoes also over here for North Dakota, a little bit of northwestern Minnesota from that system that's coming in. That is about it, everybody. Oh yeah, and still showing that this system over here at Gordon is still going away and not coming towards the United States. Now, you can see the latest information from National Hurricane Center giving it a 50% in 7 days, 50% in 40 hours just to become a tropical or subtropical system. But you can see here, regardless of tropical or subtropical development, it is going to be bringing some gusty winds, some heavy rains, and the potential for flash flooding or coastal flooding. So you do need to watch out for the riptide still. Latest update on Invest 95L shows it will start doing some strengthening from this point. Now, whether it reaches landfall in the next 12 hours to 24 hours or a little bit later, either way, it's still going to be somewhere around 40 to 50 miles per hour winds on this system right offshore. You can feel a little bit maybe right along the coast, but all these winds are going to be offshore. What's on land is not super huge. Just watch out for tornadoes, I think, is going to be some of your biggest part. This is just bringing some thunderstorms, that's bringing some winds with it, and a lot of threats is going to be right along the coast. When you look at an automatic tropical cyclone forecast, you can see where it's forecasted to go right onshore within the next 24 to 36 hours. And right east and north of it is where you got that tornado threat. That's why you have that area chances for tornadoes. And you see a few ensembles say it could get carried a little bit further north, where it could impact a little bit further towards Virginia, maybe southern Maryland on some heavy rainfall. But you can see with the Euro that it actually brings it up to a 50% chance of becoming a tropical system. Either way, it's going to run out of time and the impacts will be the same. Now, you can see what I'm talking about on the next system. You can see the update showing still as it goes towards Central American Gyre that we're going to have something start forming up, and it's going to curve right around this direction. It could either curve around by Cuba towards the southeast, potentially even curve really strong, and just it'll bring impacts to people, but it won't be against the lower 48. Or it could go further to the west and do something else. So we do need to watch that next wave. That is going to be our next main threat. Because you can see here, when you see a little bit further with the Euro now, that as we go a little bit further towards 9 and 10 days, then you can see where that chance for formation to be. And as we go past 10 days, you can see how it curves around and strengthens up right by the Western Caribbean and makes that curve. So we do need to watch that next wave. So you can see this whole transition when you look at your 500 millibar vorticity. So as we go towards tomorrow, you can see as that system starts coming onshore, this is where you get your vorticity at. This is where you get your threat for the tornadoes on that system. And you get chances for tornadoes on these cells that comes in front of that next system. So you can see as that comes onshore, and then after that moves northward, now we're into Tuesday. Now this is just bringing you storms and some extra rainfall by then, but this system is actually bringing you a group of thunderstorms that is bringing you some chances for some gusty winds with that as well, as that all pushes to the north. And this just revolves around for quite some time. Now you can see for tomorrow, you have a few areas of marginal, nothing super big. What you have is a wind threat over here for the southwest, for Nevada, Utah, also for New Mexico, a little bit of Arizona and Colorado. And you have what's over here for the upper Midwest that's bringing you chances for the tornadoes. It is a small chance, it's a little 2%, plus what's right off the coast of South Carolina and North Carolina. So here's your cities and states at risk for the chance for a tornado for tomorrow, for Monday. And you can see this from National Weather Service. Sporadic severe gusts or marginally severe hail will be possible during the afternoon to early evening across parts of the eastern Great Basin to Four Corners. Isolated, marginally severe storms are possible over eastern North Dakota into northwest Minnesota during the late afternoon and evening. A low probability tornado threat may develop over eastern North Carolina. A low threat. Then as you go into Tuesday, you get that group of storms like I was showing you in the vorticity. Here's your cities and states at risk so far, not showing no big, huge tornado threat. You can see here from National Weather Service, isolated severe thunderstorms will be possible across a large swath of the High Plains region, mainly from Tuesday late afternoon into the evening. Severe gusts should be the primary hazard. So you can see here as you go through Monday, you start getting some storms right off the coast of South Carolina and North Carolina. All the main winds stay offshore. It always shows that. While you start getting some storms brewing through North Dakota, a little bit of Minnesota, nothing super huge. Then as you go through Tuesday, you can see you don't really get a lot of storms. They come late Tuesday into Wednesday, and then they dissipate just as quickly, while Invest 95L is just bringing thunderstorms from North Carolina to Virginia, then up to the northeast from Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Maryland, Delaware. You're just going to be getting some thunderstorms from that system. It's not going to be no huge widespread event. Showing different impacts, you can see with the Euro that it just hangs out all even long, brings y'all 1 to 2 inches. There's a few hot spots that might get over 2 inches. That's a possibility. When you look with GFS, this is all within the next 5 days. It takes it a little bit heavier on that rainfall right on that pivot of South Carolina and North Carolina. Y'all get the heaviest amount, but not showing it goes way up towards the northeast because you still have that high pressure that is going offshore, but it's still doing somewhat of a block and bringing all the precipitation into this region. Still bringing y'all a good bit of rainfall for the next 5 days. But you can see what I said here about the wind gusts. So you can see with the Euro, all the winds will remain offshore. You might get some 30 miles per hour wind gusts. That's about it. Might get up into the 40s right along the coast, but not showing any serious impacts. GFS takes it the strongest, where you might actually get up to 50 miles per hour wind gusts for a moment as it starts weakening down and just carries around, bringing y'all thunderstorms. Nothing super huge coming with that system, just bringing y'all some good rainfall. But you see where you have the widespread 40 miles per hour wind gusts coming with that other system, maybe a couple pockets of 50, not showing nothing super big neither. But once again, you can see if Invest 95L does get a name, it won't make a difference anyway, but it'll be Helene. And then the system I've been talking about here could potentially be Isaac, be the I name storm that we need to watch for. You can see this with GFS showing we have that strong anomaly coming, a potential favorable environment as we go from the 20th through the 24th, right into our region of the Gulf or a little bit eastern right around Florida. We really need to watch out for that. And still showing as we go to the beginning of October, we have another strong system coming. I've been showing October 1st for a very long time. And you can see the same thing with the European as well. So as you go by the 21st of the system, this is showing it's a little bit further towards the east. So this would be more like right around Florida or the southeast of the lower 48, maybe even right up the East Coast, maybe even a little bit further away. Well, it won't bring no impacts. We got to watch out for Bahamas. We got to watch out possibly for Bermuda. Then we have what happens right at the end of September, right at the beginning of October. Seen by Ural, seen by GFS, and the Ural brings a stronger system, showing we're still going to have multiple cyclones forming. Maybe into the Atlantic, maybe into the MDR, probably into the Atlantic coming a little northern off the coast of Africa. And we still have that one October 1st. Seen by the Ural, seen by GFS, and we follow that since it was way down here. So far, the latest trend shows that as we go around September 21st, September 22nd, still in that region, that it's going to form up a low pressure. Now, it's either going to form up real strong and go right into the Gulf of Mexico. Next run showed it could possibly form up a little bit northern and go right by Cuba and go right up the East Coast, maybe even be further away where it won't bring no impacts. So we have to watch out for Bermuda, maybe watch out for Bahamas, but not showing any other impacts just on this run. So this is almost our best case scenario on this system. And when we look at the ensembles, you can see with GFS showing that we have a lot of chances for systems to form around that time and potentially go right over Florida with that system. You can see it's trending. This is with the Canadian showing it pulls up, but then it strengthens and turns a little bit earlier. And this is kind of like what you would see on the potential velocity anomaly on our lift features with the Ural. So a little bit further towards the east. So we do need to watch that next wave. It's going to be a strong transition. You can also see with the ensembles of the Canadian showing that is where something more likely is going to be forming up, and we need to be aware of that next wave. Now, the Ural is taking it where it's moving further to the west, staying weak for some reason, so we got to watch that. Potentially could be some cold fronts involved with that. Remember, we do have that cold front coming, and maybe start strengthening up as we go through the last frames. Now, as we go to the control member of the Ural, which sees further, you can see it actually shows that it would take it right around the edge of Florida and maybe be right offshore. So we do need to watch that next wave. And then when we go by the artificial intelligence of the Ural, this one accurately forecasted Francine, shows it will remain weak until the last second and then start strengthening up and curving right around the southeast somewhere. Maybe need to watch out for a potential stall. This high pressure goes further to the east. This system don't have anywhere to go but to just sit there. But you can see the ensembles with the Ural showing it will remain somewhat weak and then start strengthening up right off the coast. So it will be very close. It'll be a weaker wave moving through, forming up late. Could we still have that big trough of cooler air coming in on the western side of the lower 48? Still going to put us in that high ridge on the eastern side. And you see it is coming in pretty deep, bringing in cooler temperatures. The coolest so far is showing around the 24th on that dip. This is going to be multiple days, but we're talking about the coldest day so far, potentially bringing you some snow as well, bringing you some 20s and 30s in the higher elevations. Everyone else feeling the 30s and the 40s. But this is going to be around for a few days as that comes on in on the western side. And that's where it's showing that you will get some snowfall, potentially the higher elevations of California, Nevada, but showing right around Idaho, Montana, Wyoming area, could get anywhere from 1 to 2 feet, just a big swath of heavy snowfall. I will keep you updated on everything I've spoken here. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Make sure you click that bell and select all. That way you do get all the updates. I will start doing afternoon updates. This right here don't look like it's going to inform into anything serious right off the coast. If it starts showing some more strength, maybe, but it's going to run out of time. The next system is going to be what's over here forming around the Western Caribbean, right over in this region. This is what we need to watch for. This is going to be our next area of investigation, I promise you. But if this information has helped you, please consider hitting that like button or even that share button down below. Let other people see this information as well and let them know what's going on with Invest 95L, that it's not going to be some big hurricane or major large storm coming across there. There's a little bit of a threat, but it's only a little bit. And I think that threat could shrink some. That next area, people really didn't need to know about, because it's going to be forming late and it's going to form quick and powerful. Now, before you go on your lovely Sunday, Psalm 150. Always give praise to God. Amen. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I will keep you updated on everything I spoke about here. If you've never been here before, make sure you click that bell so you do get updates, because we are going to be talking about a strong storm coming soon in the tropics. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And remember, above all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and everyone that is around you. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. You'll be hearing from me very soon.